Hello, and welcome to this first segment of the video series. In this initial lesson, we're going to talk about the foundational question of what engineering is. Now, a simple internet search will turn up a wide range of definitions that are all helpful to take a look at, and you'll see they all tend to revolve around a core theme of applying mathematics and the natural sciences to solve problems. Now, before we build upon that any further, we should just take a moment to establish this key distinction between the applied sciences and the so-called pure sciences or basic science. The essence of that distinction is that science, speaking now of the pure sciences, science is focused primarily on the discovery of new knowledge, the acquisition of new knowledge and understanding, whereas the applied sciences are focused mainly on how to put that knowledge and understanding that science gives us to use for particular purposes. Now, having established that, we need to go a little further in defining engineering, because there are other fields and professions that also apply scientific knowledge for particular purposes. For example, physicians and other healthcare practitioners apply scientific knowledge and understanding in caring for patients. As another example, a wide range of technicians and technologists apply scientific principles in a wide range of roles, many of which often involve interacting with engineers. So where does engineering fit in within the realm of applied sciences? Well, our main role tends to focus on the development of products and processes that solve problems by applying math and science. So it's the development of products and processes that generally distinguish us from other areas of even applied science. All right, so let's take a look at the definition used by ABET. ABET is the board that accredits university engineering programs in the United States. And we'll take a look at a quote from them. And I think this may have been revised slightly since this, but the core essence is the same. It's the profession in which a knowledge of the mathematical and natural sciences gained by study, experience, and practice is applied with judgment to develop ways to utilize economically the materials and forces of nature for the benefit of mankind. Now, as we unpack this, there are several key points worth noting. One is we have the application of math and the natural sciences. So that puts us within the realm of the applied sciences, where we have that knowledge and we're applying it. We also have the need for experience and practice as well as study, which relates to the next point here, which is the role of judgment. And that role of judgment is something I'm going to come back to many times, as it is a critical component of the entire engineering design process. So we will be coming back to that. And that judgment is cultivated through experience and practice that builds upon the study of the concepts and principles. So then the next key element we have here is the development of ways to utilize natural things. So this is where we really get to the essence of what distinguishes engineers from even other applied sciences, and the ways that we develop to utilize natural things tend to involve products and processes. So that probably, if I had to highlight one element of this that really gets to the essence of distinguishing engineering from other professions and other fields, it would probably be that. We also have the critical consideration of the fact that we have practical factors we have to consider, like economics, but also many other practical concerns that I'll get to. And we, of course, have the overarching purpose, which is societal benefit. Okay, so engineers apply math and science to develop products and processes that solve problems. Well, this is still pretty broad. Number one, it's broad because products and processes is a very wide range. It can depend on what type of science is being applied. It can depend on what type of problem is being solved. So the vast range of categories for products and processes is one aspect of the breadth of what we've just established. The other, perhaps more subtle aspect to consider in that definition is that the development we refer to when we're developing these products or processes, that development has many stages or steps involved, and we'll be getting to all of that in due course. But some engineers focus on one or more particular aspects of that overall development process, which we can also refer to as the engineering design process. Other engineers will sometimes, or teams, will actually be involved in the entire design and development process. So all of that, all of those steps can be thought of as the design process, even though sometimes semantically we're a little more likely to use the word design for certain earlier stage aspects compared to, say, prototyping or testing or validation. All of it is together the engineering design process. So it's also important to appreciate how engineering involves a combination of both creative and analytical skill sets. So, as I mentioned, sometimes an engineer or a team may be involved in the entire engineering design process with all its steps and stages and different skills and tasks. Other times, an engineer may be involved in particular aspects of the overall process. But either way, it's important for all engineers to have a foundational level of understanding and skill in the entire process. And it's also fine to have particular preferences or strengths for focusing on particular aspects of that process. So let's think a little bit about what stages of the process may tend to, on balance, lean more towards the creative side or the analytical side. So, for example, certain tasks like concept ideation, even detailed design and prototyping, tend to involve a fair amount of creativity. That's not to say they don't also involve analysis, but on balance, there's a little bit more creativity involved in those tasks. On the other hand, testing, concept evaluation, defining the requirements at the front end, these on balance tend to involve a fair amount of analysis. Again, not to say that there's not creativity in all of those, but on balance, it's a little more of the analytical side. So regardless of where anyone's particular skills or preferences may tend to be the strongest, there are a lot of opportunities and possibilities for playing an important role. So in our next segment, we're going to take a closer look at the engineering design process as a whole and start to break down all those various steps and tasks that we've begun alluding to. See you then.